Hello, Nana here. Welcome back to Path of Exile. We're playing Windy Incursion League as a solo self-found Arc Trap Saboteur. And innocence is dead. The world is burning. And Kitava must be stopped. So for this episode, the goal will be to take out Kitava. But before that, we have to fight our way through these burning courtyards. In my mind, this is always the stage where the game becomes more dangerous. The monsters here in the courtyards, they have quite some spike damage, and especially if in larger groups, they're quite dangerous. I think this is the Kato room. Yep, there's Kato. Scholar of Light. Stop burning me. Thank you. And then he transforms. Okay, more bad traps for you, and then gone you are. Aha, the Defiler of Light. We took you out. But luckily, I've been here once or twice now. Maybe a couple more times than that even. And knowing roughly what to expect is half the battle. Ooh, Alpha. There we go. Incursion of Vaults. Okay, so it will be helpful to connect this one and just upgrade it because Vaults are nice. They are full of currency. I like currency. So, top one to upgrade it. And then... well, connecting it to the Corruption Chamber would be helpful. Connecting it to the Workshop would maybe even be better because then there's multiple ways to connect this arc. Yeah, so Workshop is the bottom. And this one is the top, so roughly head this way and then work clockwise. See if that is good enough. Of course, your spawn location always helps a little bit with where you need to be. And I think I said I wanted to connect to the bottom. But let's see, just do all the traps. Gone, you are. Quite a lot of rares here, more rares. Okay, plenty of time. Maybe we can get a second stone. That would be helpful. That makes this the bridge room. There. Ho ho! That was a nice last moment save. So the vaults. Okay, it is a bridge room, but it connects the entrance to the workshop, which already had a direct connection. Well, at least it's a second tier room now, and it is heavily connected to the rest of the place. So if we get a chance to upgrade this to tier 3, now we have a world of choices. Also, I had 1 second remaining. It wasn't like I really had a choice of connecting to anything except for the door next to which I found the stone. Let's see, current mana flask definitely could do with some upgrading. I'm starting to notice that I'm putting some strain on it. And well, this one also has 5 sips and it's even easier to charge, so that's definitely helpful. My bleed removal resides here right now. That is a little unfortunate. It would be helpful to have bleed removal on a health flask, of course. Let's see, Malachi's Simula, spell damage, strength, lightning damage, lightning resistance, and blood magic. So blood magic is not very helpful in combination with auras, because then you reserve them with life, which I kind of value, so might not be entirely the thing. And I'm assuming that the blood magic is a global thing rather than item specific. Otherwise it would say socketed items are benefit from blood magic. So let's assume it's global, and let's assume it is not entirely helpful for me. Not gonna reroll bleeding flasks here, because that is very much RNG dependent and has a good chance of just leading nowhere. Let's see. Yep. Look at that. There is another way to connect this. And then let's keep running. That's a bit of a dead end. Okay, nice thing is one enemy hits me. If the damage threshold is passed, then of course life. That's very nice. And then of course the enfeeble that is linked with Castman damage taken applies to usually to the entire pack. It's not gonna trigger all that often since most of the time enemies are not quite alive by the time they reach me. But every once in a while when it does happen, it's gonna prevent that burst damage. Okay, multiple objectives in this place. Taking out Utula is one of them. Getting to the waypoint, which is next to the ossuary, helpful. And then of course there's the reliquary for Kitava's torments. And after that, after we've done all the things that they want me to do, we can finally move on to Big K himself. Okay, everything is leveling. Okay, waypoints. I think I was relatively strained on inventory space, so let's empty the pocket. And then just keep stashing things in. Also, I think I have plans for this, so might as well just put it here as a reminder that at some point I should start rerolling flasks. Yeah. Ruin Square. We're next to the ossuary, might as well go here. And get ourselves a sign of purity. Let's see. That looks like the exit lever. Ah yeah, last time we were here we picked up a new kind of minion for the summoner. Those bone stalkers definitely remind me quite a bit of the abyss monsters. And there is a little ledge. Okay, hearing sounds. And indeed, those are knuckleheads. Game audio is pretty helpful sometimes for just cluing you in that monsters are just around the corner. Because if it's just very, very quiet and suddenly you hear the sound of skeletons moving, then that's a good indication of where exactly you are. Or in this case, to throw some traps ahead because the knuckleheads will stumble into them. That prevents you from just walking in blindly. But other places, it's more noisy. The music is a bit more loud. Therefore, it's more difficult to make those observations. But when you do have the option, it's the little hints that help. Okay, let's just blind that guy. Ooh. Just can't help myself. Must pick up the currency. Double check, is this the way to Mr. Annoying? Oh, that's a bridge. Bridges are good. So you see there's only one bridge here that works. So I probably made a good choice here. And then the remains of the square. Stick to the bottom end. That gets us to Utula. And after that, the bottom end takes us to the reliquary. Yeah, so next stop, Utula village. City, town. Not quite sure where I'm going with this. Trap, 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 trap. Oh yeah, he's doing a speech. Okay, yeah, he's gone. I hate it when they do speeches. Usually the speech takes much longer than the actual killing of a said opponent. Oh, a lot of video game villains seem to draw inspiration from the Dragon Ball Z fights from back in the day. Because that most of the time it's 90% trash talking and 10% action. In that regard, Kitava is just a nice and simple opponent, really. No trash talking, just gonna try and kill you. Or eat you, I suppose. Okay, oh, we triggered something. Oh, hello there, yellow. Let's see, where were you sending me? Sacrificial chamber, nice. We have one goal, Apex. That's the top left. Everything else is optional. Might as well just upgrade the sacrificial chamber to a better tier. So, top left and top. Easy peasy. Already got a stone, that is very, very helpful. Second stone, that's double helpful. And I think you were my target, so might as well murderize you. So that is one. And then of course I wasn't thinking of a second stone, so we'll connect it to this one and hope it is helpful. Plenty of time. Yep, that's gonna be good. That connects the other tier. Nice, so now most of the tiers should be connected to one another. Oh, this is gonna get me some seconds. And probably too late here. Actually got 4 seconds out of that pack. Wonderful. And that looks like a full clear. Great. This was very productive. So the apex is now directly connected to the entrance. Well, it's a very, very direct route. And only the passageways over here is not connected to anything. So the explosives room, technically not even required. I'm happy. Ooh, another mana flask, might as well ID it. Not all that helpful. Okay, so Kitava's torments means we just have to scour the place, go to all the extreme corners of the map, and pick up some kind of divine trinket that will show Kitava exactly where and how he messed up in the past. End result, he'll just become more angry. It is. Rares without group support, they are the worst. This one, for example, is much better. The arcing off of the bodies towards the rare, you get a little bit of extra damage in that way. Wait, that's not an item I wanted. So, what's in the box? Also, stop throwing stuff at me. Really. Freezes me, not a big fan. But luckily, I'm prism immune. I didn't even need to drink that flask. I am prism immune. Go, go, prism immune boots. Ooh, essence. Those are helpful. Greed is good, is what I've always learned. Thank you very much. Greed is the life essence. Life is good. Amethyst ring, well, I think I got more of those. And we now got Valakos jaw. Increased AoE. And did I just outmaneuver myself? I might have. Oh no, wait, we just continue. It appeared to be the bottom corner of the map, but actually it was just a decoy. And we get a Arcanist Strongbox. Ice Nova freezes me 7 additional items and 48% quantity. Quantity and additional items is just great on Arcanist. Because this is the effect. Lots of currency for me. I like currency. Might have mentioned that once or twice. And there we have it, Tukahama's Tooth. And then we... Wow, another essence. That is... unusual, in my recollection. Getting two essences on the same map. I think it's... No, usually you get like... Oh, one every five maps, not two on the same one. I don't really mind though. I'll just kill the boss and then take the shinies. Every once in a while I do have to recast my golem here. That one is taking quite a punishment, which is good. That's what a golem is here. Golem that doesn't get hit is a golem that doesn't do much. So good opportunity to just empty my pockets once again. Let's see, might as well put the essences in the essence box here and then the currency in the currency box. And then Lani, you wanted these things and I'll get a skill point. I like the skill point. Okay, so last time we completed herbalism, so then the journey towards arrow dancing. Well, it's a very, very short journey, but that is still the journey that happens. Bannon. Ooh, get some quality, some jewels here. Projectile stuff, don't really care, don't do projectiles, this is melee, we don't do that. So then mana regen, movement speed, and that's it. Because attack and cast speed, once again, don't really matter for this build. Okay. So now with all the distractions out of the way, time for... the angry god, Mr. Kitava himself. Okay, there's a couple of little lag spikes going on. I hope that's not gonna persist. And of course, once you notice it, it stops lagging, which is good. Just sneaky lag. It's only there when you don't really notice. And there we go, one cathedral rooftop. I must say this has gone rather quickly. Well, as slowed down as I get from all the other things during the earlier game, we're now only speeding up a little bit more. Because now we're doing both the alpha content as well as the regular stuff and still end up going through things maybe a little bit faster than normal. Of course, having a high movement speed as well as a high clear speed combines rather well. Okay. Gained a level, so arrow dancing. So my thinking for arrow dancing is right now we got a 56% chance to evade. That's only gonna go up, especially once we get celerity. So assume we'll hit about 60 or so percent chance to evade as a baseline. Grabbing arrow dancing increases the evasion chance against projectile attacks. So most of the time projectile attacks are things that attack me from edges of the screen or from slightly off screen. Archers, things like that. So it helps protect me against the things I don't really see. 20% less chance to evade melee attacks. I still got block kicking in, I still got dodge kicking in. So I think this is gonna be a very nice trade-off. So we pick it up and then it doesn't split it out. Interesting. I'd expect that the chances here to be nicely split out. Apparently that's not happening. Workshop. We already have a workshop. I don't mind the workshop. We're getting a little bit more life on the Omnitech just extends the fight a little bit, and in exchange we get item yield. I like item yield. So we kill the top one. And then, well, the top connection to the corruption chamber might be helpful just to help clear things without having to go through the hall of offerings. So we stick to the top. Another thing for the arrow dancing is, of course, I should not be in melee range with things. So if enemies have an opportunity to hit me in melee range, I'm messing up. So it's just an incentive to just do the wise thing. Okay, that one started bombarding a little bit. Flame blood. That is very helpful. Just dropping when I need it. And there we are. Got the connection, got the upgrade. So that was a successful run. Didn't get all the kills, but still. Drowning in loot means I did something, right? Okay, Hallowed Life Flask. I might as well just roll it and see it's not helpful. This one, it has no quality on it. It's just a random magic one. So I'm just trying to see if I can get insta-healing combined with blood removal would be helpful, because then the mana flask becomes available for rolling something else on it and not really having to pay too much attention to the suffix. Elemental thorns, that is something that is relevant. I do elemental damage. On the other hand, it's my traps that do elemental damage, not really myself. So any kind of backlash, it's not really aimed at me, and therefore not really my problem. Okay, overflowing with items here. So let's empty the pockets. And then go back again. Hello, Rare. Ooh, let's find you some friends. That worked. Get hit a couple times and then the traps explode and then your health is suddenly full again. Anyone? Okay, so we're wondering, where are the enemies? I need more enemies. So, just having a look here. Arc, I probably need more intelligence. Yep, okay. So next level, gonna grab another intelligence node. Eventually we'll need them. But if I want to keep my arc leveled up and doing a maximum damage possible, I need to invest a little bit in it. Okay, and we're double gates. That usually indicates we're pretty darn close to Kitava. And indeed, Cathedral Apex. Let's do this. So, decoy totem. All the traps. Let's just not be where he is throwing. And that is the first stage done. So he has the potential to do quite some physical damage, which of course is not something that I like dealing with. Do have a decoy totem. If the decoy totem is up, then that helps. Okay, we could pre-trap this one. Okay. Om nom 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 nom. Nice little heart. He's definitely preoccupied with the decoy totem. I'm very happy with that. Are we there yet? I'm not quite sure. No, we're not yet. But that heart is not really going anywhere. Oh, let's not be near the dark spots. Dark spots are scary spots. And I think Kitawa is done. Yep, he's done. Aww. Goodbye. Okay. Now we can stand here in defiance, because we know we gotta get saved. So we might as well just stand here and just face tank his Kamehameha. And there we go. One Kitawa down. And my resistances have been penalized. Yep, needs some fixing, but we got a whole inventory full of items now, or another inventory. But definitely a stash full of items. And then we can sail to Rayclast. Lily wants a favor, and after that she's gonna sell me all the gems in the world, which is very helpful. So there we are, part two of this story. This is where things get real, and I think we're off to a pretty darn good start. Definitely looking forward to some of the boss fights to see how they will be for a trapper. Guthkul, of course, is always a scary one. I wonder if Guthkul is gonna go for the decoy totem, and that it just be able to just throw traps on top of her, or if that is gonna be a very scary fight. But of course, that's not until much later. So next episode, we have some beach walking, and we have a Tukahama. After that, we have Chevron. Aberroth is no longer a very scary Rislasa. Potentially interesting. There's a lot of minions and things there, but we use Arc, so that should be relatively weight in my favor here. After that, the Brine King. Brine King, he's big. He's gonna trigger all the traps. I think that should not be too much of an issue. We're highly mobile, so we should be able to just dance around throwing traps and just have a jolly good time. I think this is going to be fun. For now though, I'm going to thank you very much for watching, and hope to see you again next episode when we start on Act 6. Bye bye.